Hi everyone, I'm Jen. I wanted to talk about what people call as NCPs, non-character players. I have my own beliefs on that, given two of my dear people in my life. One is the friend I'll call James. He actually helped me understand that I am an ME-er, a person affected by the Mandela Effect. And, you know, I liked watching all these different, you know, top 10 facts you didn't know type of things. And one of them talked about Mandela Effect. And yeah, I could see the changes, but it didn't really hit me until I came across the Isaiah 11:6, which two animals lay together. And for me to not, I did not grow up with the Bible, but for me to know the answer to that was huge, because it was a whole cultural thing from my experiences in the, quote, world I grew up in, unquote. But so I asked my militant religious friend, you know, which two animals lay together in the Bible, and he had to look it up. Now, granted, he looks up most things. He will not answer something from the Bible without specifically reading it from his personal Bible. But so he said the two animals that lay together are the wolf and the lamb. And that freaked me out because, frankly, I did not know if I was the zombie or if he was the zombie. That's where my mind went. I did not know how to handle that. But then later, maybe 24 or 48 hours later, he actually corrected me and said it was not the wolf and the lamb that lay together, but it was the leopard and the kid. A goat. I was confused. I thought there were only A or B choices in these Mandela effects, but he helped me understand that he was staying the same. Yes, he was defending different versions of his own personal Bible at home. So granted, he didn't understand. That part changed, but his essence stayed the same. He still is the sweet same friend, a kind-hearted person. Yeah, a little parentheses, duh, Jen, when talking about the Bible to me. But I'm sure I frustrate him because I don't believe stuff his way. But then again, he frustrates me because he doesn't see the Mandela effect. So, you know, whatever. We love each other. And so He is one reason that I do not believe that there are NCPs. I do believe these are human beings with souls. I believe that their higher selves are absolutely letting them know, do not believe in this stuff yet. You're not ready for it. It'll blow your mind. It'll blow your reality so much that you will not be able to handle it. And now he could see all the other Mandela effect changes, but he's very close to his version or his beliefs of his Israelite form of Christianity. And that is his life. And that would blow his mind. It would break his heart, which would break my heart. I don't want him to fall apart. In fact, I'm going to cry just thinking about it. So I don't want to, you know, wake him up, as people say. His higher self or God or however you want to term it has deemed him not to. And I think the reason why these people get so belligerent with us is because we would not respect their boundaries. We were so scared of what is going on in the world that we want to wake up everybody, but really that's not for us to say. Nobody really woke me up. I don't think, you know, I think we each had to be wake up in our own time. And then also with my youngest child, she also is definitely has a soul and a spirit in her kind-hearted human being costume. We can talk about anything and everything. She loves me. I love her. If something is planned for the next day, she'll then say, hey, have a good time for your cup of coffee with so-and-so. Or, you know, there's always that back and forth feedback. And then the following day, she'll say, how was that cup of the coffee with the so-and-so? But like when I talk about the Mandela effect, she shuts down and, you know, had at one point forbidden me to talk about it because I wanted to wake her up, not yet understanding that it was not for her to wake up. Who am I to rush the growth of a sapling turning into an, you know, tall oak tree? So, you know, when I told her, ooh, you know, there's this big YouTuber with the Mandela effect who wants to have me on his show, you know, that's a little bit more than just having a cup of coffee with someone. But she, you know, she did the kind thing and said, well, have a good show. But there's been no interest in finding out how it went or whatever. And if it would have been an interview on any other subject, then yeah, you know, she would have asked me about it. But I believe she's being protected from this information for her own self. And so when people say these are NPCs, I disagree. So I just wanted to share my opinion.